Hi everyone, it's Gina. I'm going to scrapbook today, and I'm going to scrapbook. What did I do with that picture? Here it is. I'm going to scrapbook this picture of my brothers. They're body surfing, I think that's what you call it, down at Ocean City, Maryland. We went down there as a whole family for a few days this past summer, and I took this picture of them bodyboarding. And more than focusing on the activity that they're doing in the picture, I more want to focus on their relationship and scrapbook that. But this is one of the few pictures I have of both of them together, and they were doing something that they both enjoy, and they were acting kind of nuts, which is exactly what happens when these two get together. They act completely crazy. So that's the picture. And then as far as papers go, and as you know, I pull all this stuff out. I may use some of it, I may use none of it. I kind of just fly by the seat of my pants and see what happens. I pulled all of these papers. These are all from American Craft Shoreline, and I'm going with a color scheme that is green, blue, and gray, because I want to use this these letters that spell out boys. So that's where the color scheme is going, is coming from. I want to use this sticker, these letters, and then this letter, this sticker here that says brothers. So that's where the color scheme came from. And I pulled these American Crafts, all from the Shoreline collection, and I pulled these because I have Shoreline sitting out. And they're all variations of light blues and dark blues. And I don't exactly know which one I'm going to use, but those are the ones. One of these will be a background. Some of them will be accents, and we'll go from there. I have one little chipboard piece that I pulled out for another project. It says play, maybe, maybe not, but I pulled it out. It was sitting on my desk, so I thought, oh, we'll see. I have this. I like this. I don't know if I'm going to get the colors to match so much, but I love this flag that says together is the best place to be, and it does have a lighter blue and a green, so I thought maybe we can try that. I have this one strip of leftover paper. This is American Crafts. This is the Chap collection, and this is the Ben paper, and it has this gray. So it's just a scrap, and that's, this is also from American Craft Shoreline. It's just more of that blue and light blue. This is from Cosmo Cricut Clementine, and it's that green, so we can pull some of that color in. And then I pulled these Woodland Park label stickers from October Afternoon, and they have blues and greens, so I thought maybe we could somehow try to figure out a way to use them. So I'll go ahead and get started. I hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching. Hi guys, I'm going to go ahead and narrate what I'm doing here. And basically all I'm doing now is putting those pattern papers together to see which ones I like best with those photos. I pulled more than I knew I was going to use, but I wasn't sure which ones I liked best at the time that I pulled them out. So I'm just walking through and checking out different combinations here. And I finally decide on this dark blue and light blue wave sort of paper, this broken up kind of green chevron, and the light blue and dark blue. It's got a random dot pattern on it. And all I'm doing now is taking the branding strips off of all of the pattern papers that I've decided that I'm going to use. And I'm definitely going to use that gray. I definitely wanted to incorporate that somewhere. And now I'm just trying to figure out the placement of the pattern papers on the background paper. And when I put my photo up there, I realized there's not enough contrast between the photo and that green paper. So I'm going to need a photo mat, and I really wanted to use the same pattern paper that I used as the background to mat this photo, but I only had one sheet of it. So I'm just going to cut a square out of that background paper that's going to be hidden by the pattern paper when it's pasted, glued down on top of it. So I'm going to use that as my mat. And now I'm going to work on the arrangement of these two pattern papers on that background paper. I don't want them to go the full length of the paper, so I trim them down a bit. And then I adhere this light blue and dark blue dot. And then I'm just going to use that powder tool there to get rid of the excess adhesive that came through that hole that I cut in that background paper. And then I'm going to cut down that green. And then I'm going to work here now on matting that photo. So I'm going to cut that down significantly. You're not going to see a whole lot of that background paper, which is why I wasn't worried that the waves will actually be going in the wrong direction when I actually paste this down, adhere this. But I just needed a strip around that photo just to separate it from that green paper. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just making that a small mat.
And then I'm going to lay it out again, and I realize here that that green paper is still a little bit too long, so I'm going to cut that down just a tad bit more, and then we're going to adhere. I'm pretty happy with that now, with that, and then I'm thinking that I need a border strip to just do some more separation of these pattern papers. So I'm going to use this gray from that American Crafts Chaps collection, and I'm punching it with a Fiskars border punch. And I can't remember. I think it's called Bubbles. I thought it went well with the waves and things like that. I do have a wave punch, but I thought that would be a bit too much. So I like the idea of the bubbles with the water and things like that. So I'm just lining that all up with the Fiskars punch. And then now I'm deciding, do I want the borders to be vertical or do I want them to be horizontal? And I think vertically they're conflicting with that very busy background paper, so I decide that I want them horizontally. And here you'll see I completely messed up and put the adhesive on the wrong side. So I'm just going to use an adhesive eraser and get rid of that adhesive. And then I cut most of this out because it took a little bit longer. There you go. And because I already have adhesive now on one part of that border strip, I pulled out my craft mat so that it didn't stick down on my cutting mat. And now I'm going to get this where I put the adhesive. I'm going to get that correct now. Practice makes perfect, I guess. And I'm just going to trim those down so it's the same size. And then I'm going to mount that down. And I'm not too worried about the fact that I ripped that pattern paper because I know I'm going to cover it up, so. And here I'm just pulling those lit stickers that I knew I wanted. I really, really wanted to use that boy sticker, but it just did not work out for this layout, so I'll have to use it on something else. I'm just going to put this label. This one says together is the best place to be, and I'm going to put that one up on foam adhesive, and that one that says brothers is down flat on the page. And I'm going to use some foam adhesive to put this star on the page. It's a circle with a star in it that came from those are Echo Park stickers. I think it's called from the Boy Collection. And then I'm going to put another one of those stars up by where that together is the best place to be. And that one, because the together is the best place to be, is up on dimensional adhesive, so does that star need to be, because I want it to layer over top, so. And then I'm going to use this label sticker from this October Afternoon Woodland Park set, but I don't want that butterfly, so I'm going to use some word stickers. Actually, it's a date sticker to cover that up. And then, so the bottom label sticker I used says favorite spot, and the top one says date. And now I'm pulling all this chipboard. It's a beach themed chipboard set from KI Memories that I got at Michael's, and I'm going to use a bunch of pieces from this chipboard set to decorate this page. And I actually somehow bought two boxes. I must have gone to Michael's, picked it up, and then went back and forgot that I owned it, so. So I have a lot of options because they're printed on both sides and the words are different. So once, I wanted a different variety of words across this page to decorate it. So it worked out well that I had two sets, but don't you hate that when you go to the store and you buy something you already own? So anyway, so now I'm just working on the placement and figuring out how I want to arrange these things on the page. You'll see me go through and play around with that. Thinking about it. There we go. All right, now I think I'm happy with that. So yeah, there we go. I'm gonna put some of them up on dimensional adhesive, and some of them I'm just going to put f with flat adhesive dry, that tape runner right on the page, just to give it some texture. Don't want everything flat down on the page. I just ran out of that roll of adhesive. I need to get some more of that. I really like it. Especially for chipboard pieces. I think it works really well. And now I'm going to write in the date and the place where these pictures. Oh, yep, there we go. There's the date. The date and the place, and now I'm thinking again. I don't plan out my layouts, and so it takes. So I cut most of the thinking out when I'm recording a video. So now I'm looking at some. These are authentic labels. They have words on them. So one of them says, "A brother is a friend given by nature," and the other ones, the two that I put up there, say, "Hanging out." And now these are some seashells that I bought at Long Beach Island. either bought them there or at the Outer Banks, but they came in this little, they're just little seashells. So I'm going to use a few of those to decorate the page. It's a very themed layout. I tend to do more themed layouts, I think. And I'm going to put them up on dimensional adhesive because they're concave and they don't, you know, they won't stick with other, any kind of other adhesive. So I have to fill up that gap that's underneath the shell to get it to stick. So that's why we're using dimensional adhesive here. So I decide on that. I'm happy with the way that looks. And I know my journaling is going to go in that bottom left-hand, on that bottom left-hand piece of pattern paper, so I'm not worried about filling that up, but I know I need a title, so now I'm going to look through. You'll see me pull out a bunch of different thickers to try to use, and I'm looking for a blue that I like, and I want to use a green. I'm going to make the title Catching Waves. So I'm just pulling a bunch of different, and these are the thickers that I finally decide on. They're a vinyl thicker, and I really like that font. But then I realized there's no W. I mean, something was missing there that I couldn't. I think it was an E. I didn't have an E in those vinyl thickers because most of the time I do my titles all in the same color, but I didn't have an E in those vinyl blue stickers thickers. So I decided these are a very old Heidi Grace sticker sheet for, I got them at Big Lots, I'm pretty sure. And they worked pretty well, and the colors matched, so I was happy with it. And I left the cutouts of the E and the A. And then I'm going to arrange this, the word catching, around the word waves. And I didn't want it to be straight. I kind of wanted, it's going to curve over the word waves, which is what I wanted. There we go. And now you'll see that I'm concerned about, I'm going to do my journaling right now, but I'm concerned about that top left-hand corner there. It's plain, and I could have left it that way, but I don't know. I don't do, like, there's some negative space up there in the top right-hand corner, but I think because of the pattern paper is so prominent, I don't worry about that one as much. But up in that upper left-hand corner, I felt like it needed something. So after I'm done my journaling here, you'll see that I'm going to think about that because I don't like that empty space above the word catching. So I'm going to go back to my KI Memories chipboard and see if I can find something that I like up there. So I'm definitely going to use that chipboard piece that says Beachcomber. And then I'm going to find these two. I thought about using some waves, but it didn't work. It didn't like take up enough space, and there wasn't enough contrast in the colors, so I ended up using these two sand star or starfish